It's not that.
Did you do it?
No, that doesn't.
I brought graham crackers. So, as you can see, this is boiling in here. Well, it's kind of calming down as the glass loses the heat energy, is transferred into the nitrogen. It will kind of calm down a little bit, but that's what liquid air looks like. This is just nitrogen out of the air, where you just take this air and compress it. It actually gets very hot. But then if you cool it, you keep compressing it and cooling it and compressing it and cooling it, you end up with this. So this is done on very large scales. Nitrogen is used for a lot of different things. What could you use liquid nitrogen for?
Dippin' Dots.
Ice cream? Yeah, Dippin' Dots, it could do that. And actually, there is a famous chef that uses liquid nitrogen to make ice cream. It's supposed to be very tasty. And actually, Mr. Jones makes a pretty mean ice cream dish, although we didn't buy all the ingredients for ice cream today. So we're not doing ice cream. It takes a lot of liquid nitrogen. But you could. Anything else we could use this for?
Murder.
Once the person has been murdered, and let's say we want to preserve
them. Why?
Because it's upside down.
That is good.
Anyways, guys, have you ever heard of somebody being cryogenically frozen?
Yes.
That's what they put it in.
Like stupid rich people, right?
Yeah.
Like stupid rich people. They have nothing better to do with their money. Yeah, they'll put you in a big vat of liquid nitrogen and freeze you and then bring you back to life someday. I don't know what the plan is. But people do that. There's a company that will freeze you for several thousand dollars a year and keep you in the liquid nitrogen. They have some hope that they will be done back. Guys, this is your, basic tea kettle that we would boil water in. How do you know when the water is boiling in the tea kettle?
Basketball players
doing
that.
Oh!
It whistles!
Standing on my desk.
So, here we are just boiling the liquid nitrogen. And of course, when it turns into a gas, it probably takes up, maybe about 700 times the volume of the liquid. So, that expansion. So, that's pretty cool if you can touch that.
Whoa.
It's a little bit chilly. Now, Kayla brings up an important safety tip. Don't drink the liquid nitrogen. Believe it or not, there was a restaurant bar in England, and I think this is done some places, where they put liquid nitrogen in the drinks. And what it does is it makes it all smoky and cold, and it's very cool. Well, one of the patrons actually ended up drinking while some of the liquid nitrogen was still in there, and it froze her stomach, and she had to have her stomach removed. Do they do stomach transplants? I don't know. Can you make one in a printer? I don't know. Who wants to donate the stomach? I don't know.
If you have a stomach, all you need is like a plastic bag and some.
I'm still here.
What?
Wait a minute, Bonch has got the answer. He's gonna spoil all the fun for us. But go ahead, Bonch.
Hey.
Why is it that I'm able to put a thumb in here without it killing me?
It's because your finger is like so hot that it's like, oh my gosh, you know, like.
Okay. Actually, what Bonch is really trying to tell you guys is that this just demonstrates the lightning frost effect. Do you ever throw like get some like water that lands on a really hot griddle or a pan, and it kind of just it doesn't really sort of balls up and kind of dances around on it. What's happening is that water on a hot griddle evaporates. And you get a layer of steam in there, water vapor, that it kind of rides on. Well, it's sort of the same thing when you put your finger in there. It vaporizes the nitrogen. And so then you just have nitrogen sort of gas around my finger instead of liquid nitrogen. And then it absorbs less heat. There's fewer molecules there to carry away the heat. So you can do that for a moment, but then your finger gets cold, and then the liquid nitrogen hits your skin, and then it really hurts, and you get frostbite. So, to really demonstrate how that works, we're going to bring out the stunt finger. This will. These are the cheapest hot dogs I can buy at Meijer's.
Mr. Jones.
Jumbo Franks. What's wrong? You know what? These are chicken. First of all, hot dogs are not meant for human consumption. Secondly, you wouldn't eat these, they've been sitting in my car all night. Okay. While our stunt finger is cooling down a little bit. Okay, wait, we have a question.
But if you freeze them, aren't you freezing all the bacteria and then it won't matter?
It's still a chicken hot dog from Meijer's. Everybody will be gas laws. There's a relationship between temperature and volume.
Direct.
For bonus points, do you recall the name of that law? There is one of those guys. First name Jock. Jock. Charles. Charles the law. All right. So here's. Next question. How many balloons can I fit in this Dewar flask?
A million.
1 million balloons. No, not even one. Okay, the answer is 7. I could. No, 7. That's it. That's all I'm putting. So now, if we take these guys out of here.
And listen.
Yeah, listen.
Don't touch it.
Don't touch it.
Don't touch it.
Because they don't work.
Yes, well.
What?
Learned a lot.
So you see what happens on the gas as we approach absolute zero. It goes away. And then we can reuse the balloons again a lot of times. Yes. Alright, so let's see how these stunt figures are doing. This would be my finger if I had left it in there. And this is typically what it would do to any kind of solid materials. So, what do you suppose would happen if I hit it with a hammer?
Explode.
Okay, let's try this. Now, before I do this, I, you know what, let's move it up. Okay, we ready?
Yeah, we don't care about boxing, we care about...
It's like a rack, isn't it? Well, it was. Now it's melted. No, not really.
I'm glad you're having fun, Jay.
How about
please don't eat it.
Alright guys. So what will happen then to a racquetball if we put it in there? This is hollow like a balloon. What do you think might happen?
It'll turn very, very cold, and actually, once you hit it against the wall, it's going to shatter into a million pieces. Now, I guess all we do now is just wait. Just imagine if flesh was just like that. Here, I put my hand in there and I smashed it.
Hey, Mr. Friedrichs, will let us know when the racquetball's done cooking.
Yeah.
Don't do that one, Mark.